Alright, so let's get into one of the nerdiest videos to go up on my channel to date. I'm gonna pull up the YouTube channel right here and talk about what we're doing here. So, I have made a lot of best perks videos, loadouts videos on Fortnite Save the World, and I'm not somebody who really speaks through opinion when it comes to my videos. I think most of my viewers know this, but we do actually calculate the things that I talk about. So when I say things like X weapon is better than another weapon, it's not an opinion, it's because I did the math. And that leads me to this old notepad right here that I used to use. I used to just do it by hand. So we would take the amount of damage we were doing with a weapon, the amount of damage we were doing with a crit. We would, in a theoretical perfect environment, calculate that the Spectre is critting 48 of those bullets out of 100, 58 of those bullets. Then we'd add up literally exactly what that number is, divided by the reload, or actually we would apply, you know, average bullet. Then we give it the multiplier, 45%. Then we multiply by the fire rate. And you'd get a final number, which is your average damage per second. We would do this math without a hero loadout. That's very important. Just our base numbers. And that is how I used to do my video. Literally, just by hand. If you guys want to check out the Stealing Electric Field video, I might even link it down below if I remember. I just did 45 minutes of math just on a sheet with a calculator prior to making that video. And a dear friend of mine, Cthulhu, or Sayel nowadays, she went ahead and just did exactly what we were doing by hand and put it in a calculator, and holy moly, did that save a lot of time. And that's what I'm here to talk about today, is a couple of calculators that are made by, I mean, it was Cthulhu did all of the calculations in the actual spreadsheet, but it was the exact same math that I was doing by hand as well, because it's not even my math, so to speak. This is just how you calculate. There's not another way to do it, really. And so let's just get into it. So right now I was looking at my hacksaw. So I'm going to plug my Chaos Engine video down below, because nowadays some things have changed. You don't need a reload perk on the hacksaw. So let's start with this. I plugged in, this is how you use the calculator, by the way. I plugged in, by the way, just one more final clarification. This is how you should do it if you guys are going to compare to other people. Two things you need to note: your loadout, make sure you got no damage bonuses. This counts for melees as well. And your power level. I am 137 now. This will come into an account in a second here, because I was 131 for most of these numbers. This is for personal background use, by the way. That's why this long list of weapons without any perks. It's because she and I knew what we were doing. We know what perks we had, and we knew what we were working with. This isn't supposed to be infinitely readable. Like, Bobcat, we both knew that we had reload, double crit. No, we had reload, crit rating, crit damage, and damage to afflicted. So we didn't need to write that down. And Hemlock with explosions, I know that they were calculating the five hits and adding on the, let me just get that out of the way. So this Hemlock here, the hacksaw at 225k. Let me go back to our hacksaw perk here. This does get into the story. The hacksaw was running damage, and then we had reload speed, damage, and I think it was damage to slowed and snared, but it's the same 45%. It doesn't really matter either way. And what we do is you enter in the damage, then you enter in the fire rate. It's pretty easy to use. I personally never account for headshot percents. Some people like to worry about that. Some people like to say, well, the headshot damage is higher and an average person is going to hit more headshots than otherwise. And that's true. I mean, like, hey, if I wanted to plug in the 14546.5, I'm going to do just, you know, 554, and say you are just laying into a smasher hitting only headshots, your DPS actually goes up to nearly 288,000, which is really, really good. And again, that number will be much, much higher with a proper loadout. You know, you throw Rescue Trooper Ramirez in there and I mean, and the number just gets higher. I like to calculate with zero, so let me get back to it. Your crit damage, mag size is only relevant if you factor in the reload speed, and it is. So, check this out. Right now, we have a mag size of 100, and it with the regular reload time, I think it's 5.1 seconds on the hacksaw. Our DPS, real world, if you account for the time spent reloading, is actually only about 136,000 damage per second, because you realize that once you run out of ammo, you're just going to be standing there doing absolutely nothing for 5.1 seconds. So when I've been recommending reload all these years, I was actually, back of the way, upgrading your DPS to 166,000. Kind of see how that works? I usually like to factor without reload speed. It just makes for an easier conversation to have. But this is relevant. And in fact, when you calculate reload speed, you'll find that the Blizzard Blitzer AR is actually the highest DPS weapon in the game. Or, well, AR in the game, if you account for reload speeds. But that is where our story gets interesting. So I just wanted to say that if you take away the reload speed, make it zero just to remove it from the factions here, the factoring here, my new hacksaw damage is 232. Yeah. What good those 7 power levels did me. I have put pretty much all of my survivor superchargers into offense, and I've gotten 7,000 extra DPS with my hacksaw. Go me. Not a big change, I know. However, all right, let's get into the fun stuff. So what I've been doing is, because I've been using Chaos Agent, who activates a reload whenever you use an ability. So anytime I want to reload my hacksaw nowadays, I just throw a grenade or I shockwave and I get all my ammo back immediately. So we can just bring this all the way up to 1364 point whatever. And then you can see my new DPS is about 279,000. If I'm using like Rex Jonesian support, I can just bump that to 3. And now I got a 306,000. Again, loadouts make things much stronger. If he's in the lead, 362,000. Although I suspect that number would be much higher with Ramirez. So let me just put that back to 0 because we're not using any loadout here. This is what the new number is, 279,000 for the hacksaw with that. And this isn't really a hacksaw video. It's just what I was working with. It's just a good way to show off the calculator and how it works, because our reload is now essentially 0. If you just figure that throwing a grenade takes like, I don't know, man, like 0.5 seconds, then our true DPS is still higher than 250,000. And that's really, really nice. And that's kind of what got me thinking about the hacksaw recently. And that's more or less how to use the ranged weapon calculator. If you didn't know, this has been a tutorial. You just plug in your values and you're off to the races. Another reason we have this is because sheet DPS doesn't give you the real number. You'll find that these don't match up. The sheet DPS in-game does not account for the damage to afflicted, and it does not account for crits. I don't know what sort of back-end specifics she put in, but the 45% is also not truly 45%. Technically speaking, that 45 gets added up with the 20% of nature. Then it's kind of like a 60% total damage bonus, whereas if you just multiplied 45, like, you can't just take this number times 1.45. It's not truly accurate how that works, but it doesn't matter, because like I said, this number that we're observing here isn't even what you'd get real world. You'd be throwing on a loadout, you'd be hitting headshots occasionally. You're never actually gonna, you're gonna miss some shots because bloom is a thing and damage drop off is a thing. We're just looking for a very easy to work with number, and if every single statistic here is wrong by the exact same amount, it still gives us a conversation to work with. All right, let's move on to melees. And you're going to see some jaw-dropping numbers here, because melees can get rather intense. They're also a lot more simple. All you have is damage, crit rating, crit damage, and swing speed. That's pretty much it. We also factor in Paleo Luna, because she's nuts. And I currently have a sword loadout on, I think, but it won't matter for this, because you can see I was calculating with Night Cleaves. That should be a future video on the channel. I'll link it below if I can remember, but check, you know, subscribe down below. That should be a video, because that will use this calculator very heavily, and it's pretty simple. You just plug in your swing speed and your damage, and you're off to the races. I don't know what else to tell you guys, and I will be linking the raw, the base one. So what you guys will be seeing is the original one, where there's a lot less notes and whatever. Just go to, I believe, File, Make a Copy, if you guys want to just make your own, and then you guys can edit whatever you want. I highly recommend using this. It saves a ton of time. Obviously, if you're not using Paleo Luna, just hit 0. Just take her out of the equation altogether. And then you've got the true DPS of the Night Cleave. If you don't have Luna, this weapon is garbage. It's actually so bad. But if you are using Luna in the lead, no less, it's a monstrous weapon, because swing speed is just very, very, very strong. So, yeah, quick video, quicker than I thought it would be. But honestly, this calculator was designed to simplify things, and it saves a ton of time. Hope you guys enjoyed. I figured this should have been a video on my channel a long time ago, because I reference these calculators, and I rarely actually show the math. Like, my top 10 best weapons video relied on this very heavily. When I cited that the Floor Flusher had over 300,000 DPS, it was because I was using this calculator. But it's not really exciting to show this on my videos very often, so I don't always do it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Twitch, YouTube, link down below. All of these calculators and reference videos will be down there as well. I'll see you guys later.